Merry Christmas from Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie. Last night, children around the world tried to stay awake, waiting to catch Santa Claus coming down the chimney. But what if you stopped sleeping completely? Let's explore. Make sure to subscribe to the channel down below, and if you're looking for more cool science stuff, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, what happens if you stop sleeping? The short-term effects of sleep deprivation are probably quite well known to most of us. Most people have pulled an all-nighter at some point, even if it was just to binge a TV show or play a new video game. Without the rapid eye movement sleep, or REM sleep, that our body needs, our brain begins turning off non-essential functions. As the night wears on, you will feel more and more fatigue in both the mind and the body. Certain mental faculties begin to weaken, with reaction time and decision-making suffering. The next day, you may notice that you actually feel more energetic than usual, which many refer to as being overtired. This happens because your mesolimbic system is stimulated, causing a release of dopamine. This dopamine can cause you to feel more energized. This is the main reason why you often feel more tired 2 days after an all-nighter than you do the day after. Unfortunately, that is more or less where the positive effects end. Despite the newfound energy of the new day, your brain will continue to take power away from certain areas so it can continue to function. Unfortunately, the brain turns off the areas involved in decision-making fairly early on. So while you might feel okay, your brain won't be working very well, which can lead to people engaging in dangerous activities without realizing their decision-making and reaction time are in a weakened state. If you somehow manage to make it through a second night without sleep, things can start to go very wrong. At this point, the body begins to shut down certain physical functions. You begin to lose immune system efficiency, and it becomes more difficult to metabolize glucose, which leads to even further fatigue. You'll feel extremely tired and sluggish, and will be noticeably less fit for physical and mental activities. Day 3 is when it can get pretty fun, or pretty terrifying. On your third day without sleep, you may begin to hallucinate. Visual and auditory hallucinations are somewhat common at this point, making you hear or see things that aren't really there. Unfortunately, you won't necessarily be seeing cute little animals buzzing around. You could hear breathing or voices, or see the world begin to move around you. While there is some debate on the subject, many scientists believe this to be due to a buildup of adenose, the chemical that sends us to sleep. Others believe that sleep deprivation simply allows a hidden psychosis to come to the forefront. Either way, it's pretty concerning. By this time, you may also find yourself forgetting certain things, even forgetting where you are or how to brush your teeth. This can be particularly disconcerting, as it's a bit of a rude wake-up call that things are going very haywire in the old hat rack. But what if you somehow managed to stop sleeping altogether? Well, you could see a number of ill effects in the coming days, weeks, or even months. You can suffer from still more hallucinations, develop dementia, and even die if you're awake long enough. Fortunately, most healthy individuals will succumb to sleep long before they come close to dying from sleep deprivation. The longest a healthy person has gone without sleep is 11 days before falling asleep. However, this can be very dangerous in individuals with fatal familial insomnia, an incurable form of worsening insomnia. These people slowly lose the ability to sleep, achieving less and less sleep every night until they lose the ability altogether. For these people, sleep simply isn't an option, and this deprivation can lead to delirium, dementia, and finally, death. Michael Cork, the famous case of FFI, went 6 months without sleep before dying. These months were spent in great discomfort with increasingly debilitating symptoms. Strangely, however, a Hungarian soldier named Paul Kern went without sleep for 40 years, following a shot to the head that removed part of his frontal lobe, seemingly without negative symptoms. The Dimes even made a song about him called Paul Kern Can't Sleep. It should be noted that this is not completely confirmed, as he may have been having micro naps in between. While his case remains something of a medical mystery, it does bode well for the future of sleep research. If you're interested in fiction involving sleeplessness, I'd suggest checking out Stephen King's novel Insomnia. It's an interesting and surprisingly lighthearted read. And now we return to our question, what happens if you stop sleeping? Well, in the short term, sleep deprivation can cause sluggishness and fatigue. As time goes on, the brain will begin to shut down non-essential processes. You'll likely feel a burst of energy the first day, but that will soon give way to some pretty unfortunate side effects, like hallucinations and delirium. On the bright side, there is some evidence that people can live without sleep, like in the case of Paul Kern, so hope is not lost. If you're tired of sleep, the answer might be right around the corner. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the happiest of holidays. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know the longest you've gone without sleeping.